This is unbelievable. Like, seriously? What's up, guys? Good morning. Welcome back to the channel. I'm sorry my voice is totally gone because I have like a very, very bad cold since 3 or 4 days, and I hate this. I think it's kind of a viral infection, and I have a very bad throat, continuously sneezing, coughing, bad headaches. I couldn't vlog for the past 2 or 3 days, which is like Anyways, guys, right now I have little bit of headache, but it is manageable. I'm on antibiotics as well, so I have all these body aches and, you know, joint pains, and especially when I'm holding the camera like this, my shoulder is aching. I hope this days. Actually, I put a travel suitcase down and I mounted my camera on it. Kya karna bhai, ye pura jugad karna padta, because if you want to get a good vlog, all these things are important. Talking about good vlogs, lighting is very, very, very important. Let it be a Canon 80D, let it be a Nikon, the top of the line Nikon camera. It doesn't matter if there is no ample light in the room, because no technology is as good as the human eye. Even if you spend like 5 lakhs or 10 lakhs on a camera, it doesn't matter if you don't have proper lighting. For example, if you see a movie set, or if you see a wedding shoot, they use like 3-point lighting, which is very important to get the perfect image. Anyways, that is like too much into the depth. Let's not talk about 3-point lighting and all that. Basically, what I need is proper lighting on my face. As far as your vlog is concerned, all you want is the face to be visible. What I usually do is I try to stand as close as possible to a light source. For example, in this case, I switch on the tube light in the room so that I get ample light on my face. Or in case I'm vlogging in the morning, I stand as close as possible to the window. Check this out. That's the window right there, and that's the light source. And this is the suitcase that I was talking about. Funny, right? But yeah, it gets the job done. But just check this out. If I look at me now, so you can understand right there itself that how important lighting is. Yep, isn't there a difference? So you guys, in case you have plans to start a channel and you want to vlog, don't do the mistake that I've done. Lighting is very important. There's absolutely no problem if you're vlogging outdoors. For example, right now I came outdoors, I came to my terrace, and look how beautiful my face looks. I mean, not handsome and all, I'm talking about the lighting. Nothing, like absolutely nothing, can beat the nature's light. The natural light, the sunlight is so beautiful that if you're vlogging outside, you don't need to worry about lighting. You don't even need to put any filters on your Instagram for all your Instagrammers. This is one of the main reasons I try to stand near a window when I'm vlogging in the morning. But if it's in the evening or if it's after 5 p.m., it gets really dark, then the problem starts. Just one tube light is not enough. You need to have something else. And I had plans to get the ring light, you know, the ring light that most of the YouTubers use. But unfortunately, that's very expensive and it's not easy to find nowadays. Okay, so while I was just getting ready, I just checked online about the ring light. And man, it costs so expensive. Ring lights on Amazon cost $13,600. And then there's one more brand called YONGNUOU, $11,750. Ring light hai kya? Engagement ring hai. Seriously, man, I can finish one nice trip to Gandikota and come with that. I want to get this solution done in $1,000. I know it's not gonna be that great, like a ring light where you can put a camera in between the ring and then capture yourself like properly. It's not gonna be that great, but it gets the job done. I'll show you. Yeah, that is my Sandro, and yeah, I still do not sell it. Kisi ko lena to, just send me a mail. I'm gonna sell this for around. Send me a mail actually, let's discuss. And if you're from Hyderabad, it's better, guys. All that straight transfer tax and all that, I don't wanna get into all that, so. This was like totally driven by my dad. This car has covered like 59,000 kilometers, and most of the kilometers has been driven by my dad. He never got serviced this at any other place except the showroom. Actually, we have three cars right now. The new one, which I'm driving like almost regularly every day. The Sandro and the Accent. I think we're gonna keep the Accent because we need two cars at home. I'm sure you guys will go mad right now because you know that I don't remove covers. This is a bloody 10-year-old car and it still have covers on it. Check this out. But yeah, only this part. So yeah, in case anyone is interested from Hyderabad, please do let me know. Send me a mail at srimankotaruvlogs@gmail.com. Please do not comment in the comment section below and ask me for the price and all that. Send me a mail, let's discuss there. And anyways, hello, let's go to the electrical shop and get some stuff for the, you know, lighting. Look at this lighting, so amazing outside, right? I just got this Philips LED tube kind of a thing. And this is around 450 bucks and it's a normal tube light, white. And I always prefer having a white light rather than the amber color. Shit, I hope this is working. I checked it there, it's working, but can you hear that sound? The wire cost me somewhere around 20 bucks with the plug, 470 rupees, and I've got myself a good lighting system. I know this will not spread the light evenly out, but it's definitely better than shooting in dark, right? And man, my voice is like, I feel like there's some volcano erupting in my throat. Okay, now there is my setup, guys. I attached the two leads to the two leads of the tube, and I taped it so that they don't touch together. If that touches, then you'll have a spark. Plug this in. Yes, and now see. Now this area has a lot of grain, right? Just switch it on. Wow, look at that ample light, right? Perfect, right? The only problem right now is, the main issue is that I need to make this stand, because obviously I can't hold it like this and stand while vlogging. So I'll have to figure out a way to mount this somewhere. For that, actually, I have a small solution. When I started vlogging, I used to use this tripod, which is like 30 years old. And later I got this Joby tripod, which is nice and flexible, and I can just put it around anywhere. This is like a standard tripod, just with three legs, with legs that you can extend, like that. I'm gonna try and mount that tube light over this. I think I can do that. Let's do it. By the way, I think you're able to see all the behind the scenes of my vlog. You see this one? That is where I mount this camera, usually in this room and talk. And nowadays I'm not going down in the hall and vlogging because there's a lot of disturbance going on at my place. So all I have for the next 3 or 4 months is this room. I hope it doesn't make much of a difference for a few months, because all we need is a quiet, peaceful room to talk to each other, right? Alright, so I just fixed this tube light on the tripod. Just take a look. I somehow did some jugaad to fix it. Actually, I got these two clips, something like this, that slides over the tube light like this. Alright, that's like a holder for the tube light. I mounted this on the tripod's screw. Now this solution is not a perfect solution, but let's hope at least it works. The only way to know that is to test it out. Let's do it. 3, 2, 1. 3, 2, 1. Ha! I know it is too bright right now. I need to do some exposure settings on the camera. I'll do that later. And this brilliantly works when you have a bright light source behind you. I always had a problem vlogging because always I had to face that side so that light falls on me. Now I can sit any side and just switch this on. Isn't this 500 bucks solution worth it? Arey, ruko bhai. This is unbelievable. Like, seriously? I don't know why I was making this particular vlog about lighting and all that, but I got something related to that. A lot of you guys were suggesting me to get the auxiliary lights, aux lights. Actually, even before you people told me, I was working towards that. And if you have guessed which brand is this in the next 3 seconds, hit the like button. One clue for you. Instruction manual, feeding battery cable with zip tie, crash bar mounts, a clamp, a few nuts and bolts, the main hub where everything gets connected, there's a dimmer, on off switch, and a few screws. Okay, this is something interesting actually. These are the lenses you get You know, this is a clear lens, this is the amber lens. This can be used on the clear water lights when there is like a lot of fog. Two of these for each of the lights. This is the clamp that you get which holds the light in place. And then there is the light itself, the jewel. Oh my god, look at this size. Nice, bloody premium quality, man. I think it's all laser cut metal. That's it guys, that's what you get in the box. Special thanks to Glenn, the founder and the CEO of Clearwater Lights. And an extra thanks to Kurt for making all this happen. Kurt, I'm waiting for you in India. I want you to come to India and ride along with me. Glenn, like I told you, he is the founder of Clearwater Lights. And Kurt heads the business there. And he's an amazing rider himself. So guys, here's the deal about Clearwaters. There are like four models you get in Clearwater Lights. It starts from the base variant to the top end variant. Glenn, I'm not really sure if this was your idea, but you name these products with style. You know, generally if there is a car or any other product, it's got SX, SX Plus, something like, you know, a Hyundai does. But this guy, he named it Glenda, Darla, Krista, Erica, and I totally love it. Anyways, Glenda is like the base variant which has 800 lumens. That's what Kishore has it on his bike XRX. Those are like the base variant. They are like 800 lumens, okay? 800 lumens, remember this. 800 lumens and they light up an entire street like daylight. And then there's Darla, which is 2000 plus lumens. Krista, which is 2400 lumens. And then there is this one, the Erica, 6000 freaking lumens. And the best part about these lights are they consume less power, hardly like 60 watts for 6000 lumens, which means your bike's battery will not take at all. And the way these lights are designed, they are mostly focused towards the road and it will not affect the oncoming traffic much. Hopefully maybe tomorrow or day after tomorrow I'll go and get these things fixed on the bike. And I can't wait, man.